Fire services across the country, they're encouraging more people to become on-call firefighters. This is all part of a new campaign. Only 7% of firefighters are women. 7%. And Surrey's former Deputy Chief Fire Officer has been urging more of them to consider a career in the service. Sabrina Cohen-Hatton, who's now in charge over at West Sussex, has been speaking to BBC Radio Surrey's mid-morning presenter, Sarah Gorrell.
When I got in, I was woman number 7 in a workforce of 1,700 men. So it was really, really small. And I'd tried really, really hard to get in. I applied to about 30 different fire and rescue services, actually, before I was successful. But equally, there are things about the fire service that people don't initially think about, because people have a really fixed idea of what a firefighter is, a really set stereotype. And when you say to the general public, think about a firefighter, you can guarantee that most people will be thinking about a stereotype. It's a quite a set package. But the problem with that is that so many people could be missing out on becoming a firefighter, who would make brilliant firefighters and make such a big difference to the community, because the kind of skills that you need to be a good firefighter are being good under pressure. It's about working well as part of a team. It's communicating. None of those things are set by the package that you come in.
I'll just give you an example then of that stereotype, Sabrina, that came in. I think last time we were discussing something similar to this. So quite a number of texts came in saying, well, actually, to be honest, Sarah, if I'm in a burning building, I want a big, strong man rescuing me and carrying me down a ladder, not a woman. And that's the kind of thing that sometimes people perceive and that sometimes comes in.
Yeah, and it's a real shame. And I've battled those kind of stereotypes my entire career as well. But I can promise you, every time I've rescued somebody from a burning building, no one has ever been particularly disappointed that I wasn't a man.
And actually, you talk about those, you know, this is just one element, one skill that's needed. There, from what you're talking about, a lot of empathy, a lot of other skills needed to be a firefighter.
Absolutely. And actually, it's not all about the emergency situation either. We do a huge amount of work before emergencies happen to try to stop them from happening at all. We do loads of prevention work, and that can make a real difference to people, because we're going into communities, we're working with people who could be at quite a high risk of having a fire, and we're helping them to change things to stop that happening at all. So, you know, you remember the film Sliding Doors, and you think about all the people who aren't going through that most devastating day because of something that you've done. You know, so understanding communities, being able to communicate, having empathy with other people are all incredibly important skills that help us to do what we do.
Sabrina Cohen-Hatton there chatting to our very own Sarah Gorrell. Now, in Hampshire, Hartley Whitney Fire Station had its first ever all-female crew on duty this week. Becky Wallace was one of them, and Becky joins me now. Morning to you. So tell me firstly how it all started for you. How did you get into being a firefighter?
Well, I've lived in Hartley Whitney for a number of years, and I actually am very lucky that I live and work very close to Hartley Whitney Fire Station. And I have two small boys, and they loved seeing the firemen coming in and getting their kit on and then racing out the door with the fire engine. And when I got to a point where I had a bit of a change of career and was local to the village all the time, I thought, wouldn't it be nice for my boys if they had a mum who was a firefighter? But more importantly than that, the most important thing was I just felt I needed to give something back to the community. You heard there about, you know, it's not about going into burning buildings and rescuing people. There is so much that we do in our local community to support the people around us, make sure people are aware of their homes and the risks that there are and what we can actually do to improve and keep those people safer.
Well, that's fascinating, isn't it? Because you're right, we've all got a perceived image of what firefighting is and what the job entails. And actually, it's probably quite far from that. So talk us through what you did during this shift, when this all-female crew was on duty. Walk us through the shift. What did you actually do?
Oh, of course. Well, the first thing to explain is that we are an on-call station, which means we're a team of fully trained professional firefighters, but we don't report for duty. we carry a pager with us. So we carry on with our normal lives. And if the pager goes, we have to drop what we're doing and race to the station. So on
being
this particular day...
being a superhero, Becky.
So this particular day, I'd done a bit of homeschool. I'd been to work and I was just in the middle of cooking tea and the pager went. So it's a quick shout out to my family to say, right, this is what you need to do, I'm off. And got to the station and there was a crew of four of us on, which means we can crew both of our appliances. But in this instance, it was another local fire station who needed some support of a 4x4 vehicle, which is our Land Rover. So myself and Penny were part of the crew. Penny has recently qualified in her Land Rover qualification. So it meant that the two of us, for the first time in the history of Hartley Whitney, could go out together in the Land Rover and respond to that call as an all-female crew.
It sounds like so much... I mean, obviously, it's very serious, Becky, but it just sounds like a lot of fun as well.
Oh, it's... I have to say, and people laugh at me, but it is the best. It really is. Being a firefighter, and an on-call firefighter in particular, is you have the best of both worlds. You carry on with your normal life. You're there for the kids. You're there to do all the normal things, but you have that amazing adrenaline rush and you get to see so many people. I love meeting people and helping people in the community. And, you know, you get out there, you get to see amazing things. You get to learn the most incredible life skills, particularly around, you know, immediate emergency care and that sort of element of things. And it's just brilliant. I just love it.
And how unusual is it to come across other female firefighters?
Well, it's getting more common, to be honest. Hampshire Fire and Rescue Service in particular have recruited a significant number of females over recent years. Penny, my colleague who was with me on Tuesday, she was the first ever female firefighter at Hartley Whitney, and I'm the second. But it is becoming more common as that stigma around you haven't got to be a really strong butch man to do this job. There are so many skills that females can bring to the fire service over and above the basics that we all have to do, which makes us very valued members of the team.
And what do your boys make of it now that you are a fully fledged on-call firefighter?
They're very proud of me. They wouldn't say it, you know. They take the mickey out of me constantly because I talk about it all the time. But no, of course, they're very proud and they love it. You know, the fire engine goes out past the end of our garden every time we go out. So they're always there hanging over the fence, waving at me. And they like it when they get a toot and a wave and can tell all their friends.
Oh, I bet they do. Oh, my, that's every child. How old are they?
Oh, well, they're a bit older now, so they'll be a bit embarrassed. They're 13 and 11 now. But when they were a bit younger, you know, it was the best thing ever.
Oh, absolutely. So you've been furiously homeschooling as well, have you?
I have, yes. I've got one at secondary school and one at primary school still. So, yes, I'm very glad that we're coming to the end of it and we've got Monday morning on its way.
Oh, absolutely. We're having our end of homeschooling party here on Breakfast today. So what song would you like the DJ to play at the disco later, Becky?
Oh, gosh. Bonnie Tyler, I Need a Hero.
Oh, my goodness. How perfect is that? And just imagining the scenes of fireballs in Shrek 2 as the gingerbread man runs. I mean, it could not be more fitting, Becky. Well done.
Yes.
Well, thank you.
I'd just like to say that at the moment, this week is National On-Call Firefighter Week. So it's a nationwide campaign trying to raise awareness for the fire service. But more importantly, there are local stations, including Hartley Whitney, that are on the lookout for new firefighters. It comes with full training and it is a very flexible way to actually join the fire service. So if there is anyone out there listening who thinks, maybe I could give it a go, please, please do go on to On-Call Firefighter website, onto the local Hampshire Fire and Rescue Service, Surrey Fire and Rescue Service website, and take a look. If you've got that itch, scratch it.
Oh, you've been a great advert for them, Becky. Thank you so much indeed. Becky Wallace from Hartley Whitney Fire Station. I I fancy having a go now. Like she says, it is part of a campaign to encourage more people to get involved. So as she says, if you've got the itch, scratch it.